Calculus. Here's the truth about calculus. Unless you're Bob, who can logically solve rigorous problems forwards and backwards, calculus is a crap ton of memorization, which explains why calculus is arguably hard. But before we start the video, quick message from our sponsor. Alright, a message from our quick sponsor. Just kidding, there's no sponsor. This is self-sponsor. Alright, so watch this. Alright, so this is a derivatives
handbook, textbook, book, but essentially explains derivatives at the most easiest level possible, but to an extent where you can still fully master the concept of derivatives.
If this interests you, link will be in description. Oh yeah, and I also forgot to mention that this book is made by me, and also the book is on Amazon, so yeah. Two major concepts in calculus are derivatives and integrals. Learning derivatives is like crafting a sharpness 5 netherite sword that will be used to defeat the ender dragon, which in this case are integrals. So what are derivatives? Derivatives is the rate of change slash slope of a tangent line in relation to its equation. What does this mean? Okay, so let's say that we have a hypothetical function slash curve in this case of x squared, which would look something like this. And so in x squared, let's draw a hypothetical tangent line in respect to x squared, which would look something like this. Okay, so the slope of this tangent line is essentially what the derivative gives us. And we can practically do this for any tangent line in respect to x squared. So the slope of this tangent line would be what the derivative gives us. So essentially, like it says on the bottom left, the definition of a derivative is a rate of change slash slope of a tangent line in relation to its equation. So now that we understand the concept of derivatives, how do we find derivatives? So the main formula for derivatives is this, and it's derived from finding the slope. Wait, what the heck is that limb symbol? The limb symbol is like an Articuno from Pokemon. An Articuno looks like it could eat a mouse in 2 seconds, when in reality, it's the other way around. And that's exactly how limits or limbs feel too. It looks like it could confuse and defeat your brain, when in reality, it's the other way around for that one too. Limb is short for limit, and in the limit above, it's essentially saying, as h approaches 0, y will be whatever number appears when plugging in 0. In other words, it's literally just plugging in whatever number the limit gives. Pretty easy, right? So back to this formula. It's derived from finding the slope of two hypothetical points on a hypothetical function. After cancellation and simplification, we get this formula. We add limit of h approaching to 0 because we're trying to find the slope of a tangent line of which only touches one point from the hypothetical function. This whole derivative formula essentially means that if we have an equation such as x to the power 2 that we want to find the derivative of, we can simply just plug in x to the power 2 and get a new function of 2x, which is the derivative of x to the power 2. But obviously, for other functions, it gets a little more complicated than just plugging in its formula. And so here is where it gets a little bit more challenging. Solving each derivative logically with no knowledge except this formula would almost be impossible, or is impossible for some questions due to the division of zero not being a thing. This means that as time progresses in calculus, you'll soon forget about this formula and begin the replacement of rules. There are many rules in calculus that apply to derivatives and integrals, but for derivatives specifically, there are 10 specific rules or concepts you need to know to master derivatives. Each of these rules applies to every different type of function. The power rule is the most basic one out of all of them, and it's essentially taking the exponent and multiplying it with the coefficient of the variable and then subtracting away 1 from the exponent. So for x to the power 2, the derivative will be 2x. You need to keep in mind that every rule in derivatives has its restrictions.
For example, the power rule applies to functions of which their base is a variable. If the exponent was a variable, the power rule would not be applicable because the power rule only applies to functions where the variable is the base. As you explore new functions and rules in calculus, you'll encounter integrals, which involve more rules. Integrals are antiderivatives. This means that integrals are derivatives backwards. That's why there's a dx next to every integral problem. Let's solve the most simplest of antiderivatives slash integrals, which is this. Now, since integrals are derivatives backwards, we could use the power rule for the specific problem backwards. Since we're working backwards, let's first add 1 onto the exponent, since that's the opposite of subtracting 1 on the exponent, as said from the power rule. Next, we need to find the original coefficient. Since the exponent is getting multiplied with the coefficient, we could divide the coefficient by the exponent, which in this case is 3. There, we have now found the integral of 5 times x to the power of 2. We can do the same thing for 8, where we add an x, or 1, to the exponent and divide the coefficient by the exponent, which in this case is 1. So since the integral for 5 times x to the power 2 is 5 divided by 3 times x to the power 3, and the integral for 8 is, 8 times x, the integral for the entire thing would be this. The c is there because c is a hypothetical constant, and we will never know if an integral slash antiderivative has had a constant or not, since the derivative of a constant is always 0. And so that's calculus in a nutshell.